Well, with the dramatic growth of wind towers across the state, there's an ever-growing demand for workers to service them. And here to tell us more about the training it takes to get inside this lucrative career is our Andy Barth.
Well, Rob, the wind industry is sweeping down the plains as wind turbines multiply on a daily basis. And with this rapid growth, more jobs are now available, but the training is intense. These massive towers can reach as high as 350 feet, and the only way to the top is straight up.
We see them everywhere. Wind turbines. They line the horizon like telephone poles along the road. But it's what's inside these giant structures that most people aren't aware of. A straight climb to the top. Sean Hughes is a wind tower instructor at Canadian Valley Technology Center and says this industry is very beneficial.
It's really good for Oklahoma as sending people out to the workforce. Then we get to train them. They come in here, you know, maybe working a dead-end job, and then they get to go out and get a career in a good field. I mean, I was in the field for 4+ years, and I had really enjoyed it. It's good for your family, and I mean, it's good for the workforce in Oklahoma.
An essential part of the training is learning how to safely rescue a climber, no matter how high they are.
Most of these wind farms are in rural areas. You know, fire departments aren't going to go up these towers. They're a bunch of volunteers. So as you can train a employee to go out here and do a rescue, you know, great. You know, it gives them a better chance for the ambulance to get there or get them to a hospital where, you know, they have better care.
Jacob Mersman is a student in the wind training program and says the wind business is taking off.
I think the wind industry is about to be a really big business, and I heard about this program and I hear it's one of the best, and so I decided to do what I could to get in.
And for Mersman, he hopes to climb the career ladder.
I'm hoping this could be my only career for the rest of my life. I mean, so far I love everything about it, and I couldn't see myself doing anything else.
He's through the hatch.
Practical training for real life applications.
It's very realistic. The ones in the field are a little bigger, but same thing going on. You're putting your machine up, you're bringing the guy up, and you're sending him down. Same exact thing that you'd go through in the field.
Powering our world, one step at a time.
Now, the American wind power has blown through a historic milestone. The American Wind Energy Association announced the U.S. now has a 50 gigawatt electric generating capacity. And with this capacity matching that of nuclear energy, wind power is becoming a reliable source of energy generation.
So, Andy, I have to ask, I saw you shoot guys going up and coming down. Did you join in?
You know, Rob, I did. And as a person who's not a fan of heights, I was pretty shaky. And not only that, the gentlemen who climb these ladders go through intense strength training just to make the 350-foot ladder climb. Now, myself, I didn't have that training, and because of the climb that I had to make, even though it was only 150 feet, my arms were so sore the next day, I really couldn't use them.
Well, sounds like quite an adventure. Thank you for doing this story. Now, if you want to see another white-knuckle climb up one of these towers, just head to our website at okrising.com, where you can see if our Lisa Hines was any braver strapped in on top of a turbine.